what you do is you go where the story takes you. I mean, you really sort of sometimes you have to be on location because it just demands it. When I did Star Wars, I had to come up with environments. You know, if you think of outer space and you think of other planets, they're all basically deserts. So that was a natural.
To be able to go, you know, 25 years ago in the middle of the desert and take this English crew and the movement of that was bold, and it was also foolhardy, and it worked.
I thought we were crazy.
Yeah. I thought you were crazy.
Well, everybody did.
Yeah.
But that's all right. I'm happy now. The most difficult and challenging location was in Norway, Finsko, the Hoth ice planet. We ran into, blizzards and whiteouts and all kinds of things that slowed down the production, stopped it for days on end. You know, we didn't go to Norway to go skiing, and, you know, we didn't go to the desert to get a suntan, and, you know, it's like basically you're trying to get the work done.
That was a different era in filmmaking history then. In those days, virtually everything had to be built physically, whereas we have much more flexibility now in the digital arena.
We're getting closer and closer to where we have to shoot less and less on location.
When we were doing episode 2, we were going to Italy for less than a week. We were going to Spain for less than a week. Tunisia just over a week. England just over a week. It becomes a really interesting challenge in terms of the movement of people, the feeding of them, making sure that they're taken care of.
We are arriving to Treviglia. Ah!
Ciao, ragazzi.
Most filmmakers would rather be able to focus on the work at hand and not have to deal with how do you get there and what the elements are like when you're there.
It's 10 o'clock, and I just want to shoot and get started. I don't like getting my first shot off this late.
No.
I was scouting locations as I was on my vacation, and I knew I had a scene that took place in some villa someplace in a beautiful part of the countryside that was extremely romantic. I had the exact location, but I didn't have the exact scene.
I saw a picture of Lake Como, one of the locations in Italy. It's just almost surrealistic. It looks like it belongs in Star Wars. Before this, I've never been outside of North America, so it's my way of seeing the world a little bit right now, too.
I think the thing I enjoy about locations in general is just the feeling that you're not in control, you know, that anything can happen. The case with the rain is you look at George, he looks at you. We're in a digital environment. You have such control over every single frame. We looked at each other and said, hey.
It's God's way of describing the scene.
It could be worse. It could be snowing.
Tomorrow we go to Tunisia.
Africa.
Africa. Desert. Very hot.
And action!
Just think, 24 years ago, I vowed never to return to this awful planet. And here I am, doing it again.
We seem to be made to suffer.
It's our lot in life.
I know a few of the actors that would rather not be out here. It hasn't changed too much. It's our little funky set.
All the little set pieces have been rebuilt, but these are the original little earthen craters that were there before.
It's going back to the homestead, obviously, it's like going back to where you grew up. You know, it's a little weird, and it's a little nostalgic, and, you know, there's a certain amount of emotion that goes with being back at a place you were, you know, 25 years before.
Beautiful.
I'm getting spine tingles.
I bet.
You know, the most telling moment this morning was when I saw one of the moisture evaporators.
Full reunion.
The evaporators kept falling over in the middle of a take, which was kind of embarrassing. Then in the middle of a take, you know, bits of my costume would fall off. The Jawas would start crying.
All right, let's try one more a little bit faster.
Almost any location I've shot on, I've been able to get material that I just couldn't get in a studio, or it would take a very long time to recreate digitally.
The more real things you can get in your image, the more believable those images are, and you just have to sort of tweak them sort of on set or in post-production.
All the environments that we're shooting
I've always intended to digitally change so they don't look quite as they are in real life.
Technologically, we're in areas that most people won't get to for another 3 or 4 or 5 years, and we're always on the bleeding edge of it.
With digital technology the way it is, we can recreate a lot of the vastness and the big parts of the location digitally.
And action.
So, George, why are you shooting a shot for episode 3?
I can't tell you that.
You have to wait 6 years for that answer.
6 years. How much stuff are you doing for episode 3 now?
Just this one shot. Oh. It means that now I don't have to come back here. So it's a long way to come and bring a crew of 60 people just to shoot one shot. And then rebuild the set and all the other stuff we have to do in 3 years.
What happens if you decide you want another shot?
I don't get it.